Tropical sprue. So which part of India is in tropical region? Of course it is South India. Therefore, tropical sprue is very common in South Indians than North Indians. So you know this tropical sprue question comes. Remember this gem. Gem, G for glossitis will be there, that is inflammation of tongue will be there. E for emaciation, the person will be very much emaciated. Okay, and M is for macrocytic anemia will be present. Alright. So coming to the pathogenesis. So what happens here, since there is malabsorption taking place, so whatever the person is going to eat is going to come out. So the person will have severe diarrhea. Due to diarrhea, what is going to happen? Gut bacteria are destroyed and they are replaced by the pathogenic bacteria like E. coli. That is the most common one that is going to be present. So due to the E. coli, so as soon as an infection comes, like for example E. coli infection, what can you think? Of course, the person is going to have fever. So symptoms are, the person is going to have severe diarrhea, the person will be having fever. Along with that, due to diarrhea, there will be dehydration. So the person will have weight loss, fatigue and anorexia will also be there. And this is a GI problem, therefore certainly there will be abdominal distension also. So these were some of the symptoms. So this disease, that is tropical sprue, has to be differentiated from giardiasis, which is also going to be very commonly seen in tropics. So how do you treat this condition? So tropical sprue, when it comes, remember E for E, that is tetracycline is the treatment. Since there is an infection by the bacteria, you have to at least symptomatically remove this condition by treating the person with the antibiotic, and the antibiotic starts with the first letter of the tropical sprue, that is T for tetracycline. How much should be given? That is 250 mg should be given, and it has to be continued for 4 weeks.